Okay, so this station is going to be part of your CDOT soil inspection certification. We call it the AASHTO M145 soil classification and identification. So basically what we're going to do is you're going to be presented with seven different AASHTO soils that we have zoomed in for you on a picture. And we're going to have you do what's called a visual manual type of classification. You're going to get your hands on these soils, and your instructor is going to be asking you questions about these soils' characteristics. Some of the soils are going to compare their characteristics to one another, and then from your answers, from your comparisons, you should be able to, within reason, identify which AASHTO soil type the sample is. And then from there, we will want you to know how is that specific AASHTO soil type placed, compacted, and tested in accordance with the CDOT specification. Because as we recall from the CDOT PowerPoint, different AASHTO soil classifications are going to be compacted and tested in different ways. Our more granular soils are going to be modified Proctor or T180 and compacted with pneumatic or vibratory rollers, and our more cohesive soils are going to be standard Proctor with either plus or minus 2 of optimum or at or above optimum, depending on how much fines we have in those materials, and compacted with sheep's foot rollers. So I'm going to show this procedure with you. It's fairly subjective, but with our friend here, Mr. Anderson, and I'm going to ask Mr. Anderson questions about these soils. What you need to know when you come in to certify, if you misidentify a soil, that does not constitute a failure. That's okay, as long as we don't take a very granular soil and say that it's an A7, we're going to be okay with it. The goal that we are trying to do here is for you to understand, we want you to demonstrate to us that you have a knowledge of handling a soil in your hands and being able to determine is it plastic or not, and then also being able to compare two soil types so that you can determine is one of them more or less plastic than the other. That is a skill that you will need in the field to determine if your soil type has changed, if you need to change your proctor, or if you need to change, if the contractor needs to change their compaction methods. So this procedure is to familiarize you with that, and then also we are testing to make sure that you have knowledge of the CDOT soil spec. Are you ready, Mr. Anderson?
I am, sir, thank you.
Where would you like to start?
I get to pick?
Yep.
Cool. I will go randomly.
All right. Okay, so what I'm going to have you do here, this is one of these soils that we're going to do a comparison of. So I'm going to have you compare these three soils to one another. So I want you to get your hands on all three of them.
Okay.
And when you're doing this procedure, we've already provided you with subsamples of soil and wetted them for you, but you yourself will need to hydrate these samples and get a feel for them in your hands. Did you get all three of them?
Yeah, I did.
Okay, so the first question is, do these soils contain fines, silt and clay particles, yes or no?
They do.
Now, they do have clay. Just as an estimation, would you say they have more or less than 35% fines?
I'm going to estimate that all three of these have more than 35% fines.
Okay, so what I'm doing here with that question is I'm going to direct Mr. Anderson to one half of the AASHTO chart. So because he said we're at more than 35% fines, we are in that realm of soils with A4, A5, A6, A7.
Perhaps I should also explain the reason I think that there's more than 35% fines is the way it smears in my hand and what's left behind here. It looks like there is in this bowl, and then what goes on my fingers and my skin seems like material that will pass the 200 sieve on all three of these.
Good observation. And do you feel much sand or grittiness or aggregate in these samples?
This one here, I do feel some grit, larger particles in there, but it's mostly the fines. This one here, more grit, but less sticky.
Okay. So that's the next question I'm going to ask you about. You heard him mention sticky. So now the next question that we're going to ask to help derive the classification is, are these soils plastic or not? Yes or no? Do you feel
yes,
plasticity?
I believe they are.
And then the final piece that's going to help you identify them is, can you detect a variation in their plasticity? Of the three, which one has the highest plasticity, and then which one has the lowest plasticity?
This one's pretty easy to tell that this one's got the highest plasticity.
Okay.
It's sticky. All three of these roll pretty good. They all roll really good. But this one here, just by the feel of it and the way it smears, I'm saying this one here is the highest.
Okay.
Plasticity. What was the other question?
So which one of the three is the lowest plasticity?
Lowest. That would be this guy over here.
So in order to determine your plasticity, we have to remember two things. One is going to be the plastic limit and the liquid limit, and also your plasticity index. So a high plastic soil is going to be one that holds more clay, has more clay, so it's going to hold more water and still exhibit plasticity. So two characteristics you'll see in the field. One, Brian's sitting here and rolling these samples. A higher plastic clay, you're going to be able to roll into balls and ribbons and thread for a much longer duration of time until it loses its moisture and begins to crumble and break. The second thing with a higher plasticity material is water. If we begin adding water to these samples and reincorporating that water into the material, a lower plasticity soil with a lower liquid limit is basically going to turn to soup. We're not going to be able to form it or roll it into balls or threads anymore. Versus a higher plasticity soil will absorb that water, and you'll be able to add far more water to the higher plasticity soil than the low plasticity soil. So these are exercises that you're going to have to learn and do when you're here identifying these soils. When you have a lot of experience, again, it just comes down to feeling the soil, and you'll be able to tell, well, this one's silty, this one's clay. But if you're new to this, some of these kind of tools and tips, add water, see which soil holds more water. Try to get them at about the same moisture content and see which one breaks and crumbles on you first. Again, the lower plasticity soil will break and crumble first. You won't be able to add a lot of water to it versus the high plasticity soil. So, Mr. Anderson,
yes.
Given those comparisons you made and how much fines these materials have, how would you identify these soils?
Okay. Using this chart here, and I'm looking. What stands out is the plasticity mainly, and then the granular next. So I would say we are talking, it's hard to tell between these guys which one would be your A6 or A7, but they're definitely there.
Well, of the two, which one had the highest plasticity?
That'd be this guy.
So what would you call it?
So I would probably, I would call this one A7.
Okay.
And then I guess that will pull this one into the A6 area.
Okay. And how about your lowest plasticity soil?
This lowest plasticity soil, looking at the gradation now. Now the plasticity.
Remember, we had more than 35% fines.
Yep. So I'm thinking A4, A5.
Yep. And that's really all we're looking for, is for you to consistently identify the low plasticity soil with the low plasticity soil on the AASHTO chart. So you will have the AASHTO chart in front of you when you're doing this practical, and we want you to say, this is the higher plasticity soil, so that must be the A7. This is the lowest plasticity soil, so that must be an A4 or A5. That's what we're looking for. So how do we compact those soils, Brian, with the CDOT spec, A4 through A7?
These guys will require a T99.
Yep.
The compaction equipment will require a sheep's foot.
How about our moisture content?
Moisture content. Down here, we're going to need to be at or above optimum moisture.
Yes, and since we are compacting these at or above optimum moisture, what do you have to be watching for with the completed lifts? Well, how do we want the lifts to...
Percent compaction?
When they're rolling over with construction equipment, what are you going to be watching for?
pumping?
Yes. And if you see any pumping or any rutting, what do we have to do?
Might have to dry it out a little bit.
Yep. So that's what we're dealing with. Again, we want at or above optimal moisture for those soils, but if the completed lifts are pumping, rutting, then we have to notify the engineer that the lifts are not stable, and we may have to dry these back and compact them at a lower moisture content.
Right.
These two, again, I'm going to have you handle and compare them to one another.
Okay, so there's more granular in here than this, which I said was A4, A5.
Yeah, so the first question, do these soils have fines in them?
Yes, it does.
How about the second one? Does it have fines in it?
Yeah.
So would you say more or less than 35%?
I'm gonna say right around 35%, maybe a little less over here.
Okay. So if we go with less than, again, we're directing him to a section on the AASHTO chart. So if we're going to go with less than, we're now out of that A4 through A7 range, and we're probably dealing with the A2s. So do these soils have plasticity?
Yes, they do.
Can you detect
plasticity?
Can you detect a variation in your plasticity? Is one of them more plastic than the other?
Not hugely, but I think this one's just a little bit more plastic than this one.
Okay. How can you tell?
Well, one, it just feels a little stickier.
Okay.
And when I'm rolling it, it still rolls. But it just feels like, to me, that's what I'm seeing. That I think that these two are pretty close to each other. They both have actual rock in it, more granular. So I think that this brings me into the, I'm saying A2.
Yeah, so which one was the higher plasticity? And then which one was the lower?
I think that this one's a little bit lower.
Okay, so given those comparisons in your plasticity, what would you call these soils?
So with that, okay, so I'm looking at PIs and the liquid limit. They're got to be A26 or A27 because they feel very similar with more granular, but yet, you know, again, the liquid limit and the plasticity are right, the requirements for the two are about the same.
So given that one's a higher plasticity than the other, which one would you call which? The higher plasticity soil would be your...
your A27.
And the lower plasticity soil would be your
A26.
Okay, so how do we deal with compaction of those soils? So that's what we're after, again, is the comparison and then a consistent identification. We actually have an A24 here, and again, we don't care that Brian or Mr. Anderson misidentified it.
God, do that over.
And we don't care that he misidentified. So what we have is an A24 and an A26, a low plasticity and a high plasticity soil. As long as we consistently identify a higher plasticity AASHTO soil with a higher plasticity material, then we're happy with you. All right, so how do we deal with the A26, A27? Which proctor do we reference?
That requires the T99 still.
Yep. Moisture content?
Is going to be plus or minus 2% of optimum.
And then what roller type?
And the roller type, again, it depends, but you could use either a drum roller or a sheep's foot.
That is correct, because it's granular and it's cohesive. The spec says granular soils are going to be the vibratory pneumatic rollers. Cohesive are going to be the sheep's foot. Both of these soils have kind of both characteristics to them, so we would allow the contractor to choose, and then as long as they're achieving compaction in the field, we'd be happy. How about the A24, A25? How do we deal with that soil?
These A24s, A25s are T180.
Yes.
And those are your steel drums.
Yep. Moisture content?
The moisture content is plus or minus 2% of optimum moisture.
That's correct. All right. Two more.
Okay.
Does this soil have fines in it?
This, well, it might, but not much at all.
Is there any plasticity?
There is zero plasticity in this.
And then the overall gradation, how would you kind of describe it?
This is sand-like.
Okay.
Just sand.
So given that, what soil type would you call it?
Over here, non-plastic, fine sand, I call it an A3.
That's correct. So this is an easy one. How do we deal with the A3? Which proctor?
That is a T180.
Roller type?
Drum roller.
Moisture content?
Plus or minus 2.
All right, last sample. So same thing, is there much in the way of fines in there? Would you say more or less than 35% fines?
I would say less.
Any plasticity?
I would say no.
What are you seeing? What are you seeing with the grain size?
Well, there's a variety in here, grain size. There is definite gradation in here.
Okay.
With that being said, having no discernible plasticity.
So what would you call this soil?
I would call this one, I'd call it either an A1A or an A1B.
Yep, A1 is what we're after, so how do we deal with that? Which proctor?
This is a T180.
Roller type?
It is a drum roller.
And moisture content?
Plus or minus 2%.
So that concludes this exercise. That's what you're going to be expected to do, is get your hands on these soils, compare them within reason, identify them, and then tell us how they are placed and compacted with that CDOT spec. So know your spec and be able to have some experience handling soils and being able to tell yourself whether or not it's plastic or low plasticity or high plasticity. That's it.